Welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will talk about model validation. So I will start with an example. For example, in your web API, you will have certain models or domain models. For example, I have a model called product. Okay. So a model is nothing but a class. And this particular model can have many different properties. For example, integer ID and string name and price, integer price. So suppose that I have three different properties within my model product. So when the user requests for something that is related to my model product, and probably he may be giving data or inputting data, or probably he may be creating a new product, he will be required to give these parameters in the HTTP request. But we cannot always trust user input, and we need to validate the user input before actually going and creating a new product within our database. So that is the purpose for model validation to exist. Okay. So we can use data annotations to perform model validations. Okay. So some of the commonly used data annotations are, for example, you can say something like required. So this particular annotation will be placed on top of your field, okay, somewhere over here, just to indicate that ID is required and the user cannot skip it. And you can also say something like range 0 to 10. For example, in a particular product category, I have all my products within the price range 0 to 10 or probably IDs. So you can go ahead and place that on top of your price just to make sure that user is inputting data within that particular range. And you can also use models isState.valid, modelState.isValid, to check against the validation attributes which are over here. And sometimes the user can also do something called underposting, okay, meaning that I need three different values to construct my product object, but the user may only send in two inputs, or they can do something called overposting, where they can give more parameters than that are actually defined within my product model. So this is all about model validation, which is very important because you're going to take user input and you need to make sure that the input that the user gives, which is basically adhering to your model standards. Thank you.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.